Hello everyone, I am Jasmine Theodora, and on this channel we talk about lost female education, femininity, and traditionalism. So if that sounds like something you are particularly interested in, then please do subscribe. If you are new to this channel, I'll begin with exactly what femininity is. According to Webster, femininity is defined as qualities or attributes regarded as characteristic of women. I find that a little vague, so here is my definition of femininity. A woman's acknowledgement and understanding of her God-given nature and ability to operate in it unapologetically. Today, I am covering the fundamentals of femininity, the kind of traits that every feminine woman embodies, and the reason why I'm making this video is because as women, we have been sort of denied true female education in this modern era. We have not been taught what our nature is as women and how to use it to our advantage and for the advantage of those around us. We have been exclusively taught female liberation, liberation from our gender roles, if that's what we choose for ourselves. But we have focused so much on the choice of female liberation that we haven't discussed the fact that most women are happy, content, and fulfilled in their natural feminine role. By focusing only on our freedom to gratify our transient passions and whims, we have been left unfulfilled, lost, and miserable, trying to fulfill ourselves by living out the masculine role simply because we were denied that role for so long, not because that's actually what would make us fulfilled. We've seen this play out as well. The paradox of declining female happiness is well documented. The more liberated women have become, the less happy we are. It turns out that working for a conglomerate, never marrying, and raising cats and dogs only, sleeping with tons of men, hasn't been our saving grace as women. But if you say that, somehow you have internalized misogyny. It's a mess. The world needs virtuous femininity now more than ever. It is crucial for women to understand their natures and roles in the natural, familial, and romantic, and return to them, not only for our advantage, but for the advantage of everyone. So let us begin. Number one, joy and positivity. A feminine woman acknowledges that our culture encourages pessimism and teaches young ladies that it is acceptable to bemoan and complain in front of others at the expense of their comfort. Instead, she chooses joy. She chooses to be a source of love and positivity and smiles at others regardless of her present circumstances. Note that one can still share their struggles without transferring the negative emotion. She wants to be a refuge, an emotional haven for those that she loves, so that when they need comfort, she's there to be a source of joy and love, and this gives her an incredible amount of fulfillment herself. When she's taken with sorrow or anger, she takes a moment to relax, prays to God for deliverance from her distress, and perhaps thinks of light, sweet thoughts that bring her refuge. She softens her eyes and voice while smiling authentically. The wideness of her smile should be genuine. She's not at all trying to hide who she is. Rather, she's showing the bravest and best of who she is. Number two, gentleness and softness. A feminine woman has the incorruptible apparel of a soft and gentle spirit, which she knows makes her incredibly valuable to her man in this day and age when mass media has encouraged women to be rough around the edges. Unlike those who raise their voice and approach others with disdain and sarcasm, she greets others as if it made her day to see them. When she's confronted with conflict or needs to handle a difficult subject, she handles it softly and gracefully, pushing past any disappointment and trying to only focus on how she can improve the situation. She is sensitive to the feelings of those around her. She gives solicited, gentle advice when asked, but is careful not to be judgmental when someone chooses to do something that she may not have chosen herself. Instead, she prays for a good outcome for them and is always there for those she cares for if a problem arises. Number three, cooperativeness. One of the most powerful traits of a woman that she simply cannot help is her desire for peace, cooperation, and cohesion. As the catalyst for cooperation, she endures tremendous self-sacrifice. Like that of a mother, she forgoes her own desires many times to help others reach their needs. She avoids rigidity in the face of inconvenience and does not waste time demanding things are done exactly her way out of pride. She understands that sometimes something has got to give. To achieve the flowing, comfortable, tranquil environment she desires, she takes it upon herself to nurture it and to bend in the face of trouble instead of break. She uses her temperance and patience to hold on for others through their trying times rather than draw attention to herself. Number four, compassion and kindness. A feminine woman shows that she cares with more than just her words, but also her body language and her thoughts. While speaking to someone, she looks at them with interest and understanding, truly listening to what they have to say. She greets others with a warm, welcoming countenance, delight in her voice, and love in her embrace. She has a gentle, compassionate touch, though she's always respectful of any personal boundaries. She shows empathy when she's told something unfortunate about someone else, and she offers support when friends confide in her, including any relief she can take immediate action on, such as bringing medicine to a sick friend, massaging her husband's shoulders after a long day of work, consoling a crying child if appropriate, etc. She gives words of encouragement to others and is generous with her prayers, and she imagines their success out loud for them as if to paint a lovely picture of what she believes they could achieve. She enjoys taking time out of her day to support those she loves. Her compassion is made obvious by her desire to help and nurture others. Through her compassion, she builds true, enduring connections. And finally, we have humility. In a world where a woman is not only taught that she can do it all, but that she can do it all without any help, a feminine woman chooses to acknowledge her weaknesses. She acknowledges her limitations physically. She does not need to put herself in danger by trying to carry more than she can handle. Instead, if possible, she will ask the help of a strong man near her. This will not only make her life easier by absolving her of this struggle, but will also make her man happy since he feels needed. A bitter woman would resent fulfilling a man's needs and complimenting his strength by asking this favor, whereas a wise woman will value his gesture. She also knows that everyone, men and women alike, have limitations intellectually. Some people simply are more interested in some things than others. Some are more knowledgeable in some things than others. She knows that she does not know everything and she cannot solve every problem herself, and she does not have all the answers. Her pride does not prevent her from growing, and her humility accentuates all her other feminine qualities. Well, that is all I have for you today about femininity. I hope that this makes the concept of femininity a bit more easy to understand. I know that when I was first really getting into refining my conduct as a woman, I was a little fuzzy on what it really means to be feminine, so I really hope I'm able to help other women really understand what it means to be feminine. To fully embody what it means to be a virtuous feminine woman is not something that really happens overnight. It can take months or even years of refinement and intention, but with time, it is completely possible to embody what God hopes for us to. Well, thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you enjoy this kind of content. I am Jasmine Theodora, and may God bless you. Goodbye.